Hello and welcome to another Century 21 Tech Talk Briefing with me, Jeff Tracy. In this special briefing, I'll be providing details about the operation and technical specifications of the experimental machine known as Supercar, the incredible technological advances of the modern age, which ultimately resulted in the development of international rescue craft, can be traced back to Supercar's creation in the mid-20th century. The craft was affectionately known as the marvel of the age. And thanks to Brain's research, we even have some black and white footage of the vehicle in action. The design and construction of Supercar was the result of 5 years' work and a collaborative effort between one Professor Rudolf Popkiss, an Austro-Hungarian, and Dr. Horatio Beaker, an Englishman. They built their own facility, the Black Rock Laboratory in the Nevada desert, to house many of their specialist projects, with living accommodations at the lab situated adjacent to the main control room. The Supercar team were able to live and work together in comfort, while remaining on call 24 hours a day. From the main console, Professor Popkiss maintained communications and monitored the operations of Supercar from launching through to arrival at its destination. The console operator also had the capability to pilot Supercar remotely, allowing the vehicle to be flown without a crew as required. This refinement of remote control technology at the time proved invaluable when criminals attempted to get their hands on Supercar for themselves. Police records named two characters called Master Spy and Zarin, who repeatedly tried to steal the machine for their own nefarious purposes. Mike Mercury, now something of a legend in the aviation field, was the pilot of Supercar. He was famous for his lightning reflexes and nerves of steel. On Supercar's first mission, Mercury rescued brothers Bill and Jimmy Gibson following a plane crash. 10-year-old Jimmy was immediately drafted to join the Supercar team, but he brought with him an unusual companion, Mitch the Monkey. Yeah, that's right. Mitch was a chimpanzee who supposedly wreaked havoc and mischief wherever he went. The evidence, however, also suggests that he was a resourceful and unique asset to the Supercar team. Currently on display as part of the Aviation Heritage Collection at Unity City, Supercar measures 27 feet in length, 5.5 feet in height, and 11.5 feet in width. Supercar's rear-mounted wings could be extended to provide greater stability while in flight, increasing the wingspan to over 18 feet. Because of Supercar's compact size, it was limited to a maximum of 5 occupants, but made it relatively discreet and able to land in the tightest spots. Supercar was capable of speeds of up to 3,000 miles an hour in the air. For the safety of other vehicle users, its speed was originally limited to 150 miles an hour while traveling at low altitudes on roadways. Supercar was also one of the first craft developed that was capable of vertical takeoff and landing. Once the pilot had completed pre-flight checks, Supercar was launched vertically from inside the Black Rock Laboratory where it was housed. Once the port and starboard engines were charged and fired at 15,000 RPM, the lab's roof doors were opened. If the car was fully loaded with crew or cargo, full boost on takeoff was necessary for it to ascend into the sky. At that point, the pilot would extend the wings and proceed at full speed to the desired destination. Supercar was fitted with a number of revolutionary features developed by Popkiss and Beaker. These made the craft the ideal machine for carrying out rescue missions, undercover operations, and exploring the globe. The team, of course, always endeavored to keep their operations top secret. Thanks to the careful maintenance of the Aviation Heritage Committee, many of Supercar's gadgets are still operational today. When visibility was severely limited, the pilot could engage the ClearView apparatus, which enabled perfect vision on the car's monitor through even the thickest of fog. The monitor could also display a video plan, which automatically plotted the best flight path for the pilot to take to the desired location. Supercar's versatility has remained almost unmatched in the past 100 years. It possessed the ability to travel in the air, under the water, into outer space, and even on land when required. The machine could travel to a depth of 400 feet underwater before succumbing to the pressure of the depths. It used to be called upon to rescue stranded submarines, explore lost civilizations, and to enter dangerous territories in complete secrecy. Supercar's plentiful oxygen supply enabled it to travel into space, where it used to carry out operations the likes of which NASA and the world's military organizations simply could not achieve at the time. And although it was rarely required, the supercar was capable of traveling along the road like any other motor vehicle, at speeds which I guess must have dazzled the average 1960s police officer. Over the course of their many exploits, Beaker and Popkiss invented many other special devices for supercar, which we now take for granted. Electromagnets were fitted to the car, which were originally developed for military-grade transportation, but proved invaluable when a runaway train threatened the lives of the supercar team. Supercar was also fitted with a special cannon to safely bring down an Air Force balloon that was loaded with highly volatile fuel. Other modified features included an ejector seat, a drill, a device to electrically charge the hull in order to deter unwanted guests, and even a special paint formula which was able to turn the car invisible. Brains couldn't believe it when he heard about that one. Well, folks, we've reached the end of this series of briefings. It's been a great privilege to share these details with you, and I hope to have the opportunity to do so again very soon. So from me, and everybody here at International Rescue Headquarters, thank you for your attention. So long.